All right, you know him as the lead guitarist in the rock band Kiss, and Portland knows him as a hometown hero. Today we are joined by rocker, philanthropist, and now app designer, Tommy Thayer, who is back in town to share a very special project. He has just launched his very first children's storybook app called Ernest Hummingbird. Thanks so much for being here.
Nicole, what a pleasure. Always great to see you.
Good to see you too. And I was so excited to hear about this project. I've been seeing the artwork online. How did this come about? This is a storybook app.
It's kind of crazy, and it's a little different than something I'm used to doing, which is more of the rock and roll stuff. But Ernest Hummingbird is a really sweet, heartwarming children's storybook. We made it into an app, actually. So Ernest Hummingbird's the story of a young hummingbird named Ernest who loves to hum, but actually he wants to learn to sing, and not just hum, much to his parents' dismay. So he learns to sing with his best friends, and his parents aren't behind him all the way to begin with. But as the story goes on, it's a really great little story, and Ernest finally gets to sing, and he ends up, you know, in a big way singing, and his parents end up being very proud of him, and his father's, "That's my boy."
Yeah.
And so it turns out great, but it's a really heartwarming, inspirational story for, you know, finding your way and following your dreams. And
kind of that never give up mentality.
Exactly.
Which has been your whole career, right?
It is. You know, people say, you know, how can you relate to this? And I actually can relate to it in a lot of ways, because it is about persistence and persevering, you know, never giving up on your dreams and keep pushing until you make things happen. So.
Absolutely. And this is a cool collaboration, too, to let you guys know. Cartoonist David Feast, phenomenal. Mm-hmm. Country music star Darius Rucker, you know, Hootie and the Blowfish, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
And you produced and contributed music.
That's right. I really, it started out as a story that David wrote. And we had a basic storybook with the illustrations that he did. And then we took it to the next step and made a storybook app out of it. Mm-hmm. And the app is, the Ernest Hummingbird storybook app is available on Apple iTunes now at the App Store, and you can download it anytime. But I ended up finding the voice talent, and I got Darius involved, which he narrated it, which he did an amazing job. And then I wrote about 8 or 9 different little tunes for the thing.
Oh.
And the interesting thing about it is it's not a rock and roll thing. It's really a kind of a diversion for me and doing something that I'm not used to doing, but that made it really interesting for me. Mm-hmm. And some of the tunes actually have a little country tinge.
I like this.
One of them is a little Italian aria sounding song. And then a couple other songs are more kind of pop tunes, like Best Friends Forever, which is a really legit, cool pop tune that we have some great singers. Will Champlin, who was a finalist on The Voice a year or two ago, he came in and sang a few tunes, and Sarah Nimitz, who's also an aspiring, up-and-coming singer-songwriter, she came and sang a couple of tunes. So we got great vocalists and great musicians doing this. But yeah, Best Friends Forever, another one was Fly Right, and then of course kind of the theme song is I Just Want to Sing.
Oh, don't we all just want to sing? This is awesome. And this is a great tie-in with your work with the children's hospitals as well.
Yeah, what we did was to launch the app about 2 weeks ago, Darius and I went to the Medical University of South Carolina in Charleston, which is actually where Darius lives, and we launched the app at the Children's Hospital there, and we gave the app to all the kids in the hospital.
Aww.
And they really enjoyed it, and you know, it was just to make them happy and bring a smile to the kids' faces, because these kids are going through some really traumatic things there at the hospital, and they have a tough road, so just a little bit of joy and some happiness that we can bring to the kids. That's why we did it at the hospital. So we brought a bunch of iPads preloaded with the app for the kids to share. And then also we had download cards for the entire staff and all the children in the hospital to download it for free. So it was a great event. And Darius is a great friend. And it was really cool how he stepped up and did that with me. And I think we got a lot of good response from it.
Absolutely. And it's a big network of hospitals, too. So
it
lots
is.
Of kids are going to see.
Yeah, MUSC down there in Charleston is a part of the Children's Miracle Network Hospital Network. I think they have 170 hospitals. So we're actually going to do a promotion where we are giving the app free to every kid in all the all the Children's Miracle Network hospitals.
It could be 10 million kids we were reading about.
Yeah, because they actually have 10 or 11 million kids through the hospital in the last year or so. we're going to offer it and give it for free to all the kids.
What a great thing to hear this holiday season especially. And now that you're back in town, what are your plans for the holidays? You just got off the KISS cruise.
Nicole, what are we going to do?
It's been a really big year for you. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah, we just got off the KISS cruise a couple weeks ago, which is an amazing little franchise in itself. Mm-hmm. For 6 years now, we've done a KISS cruise on the Norwegian Cruise Line ship, and
off
there's
the
almost 3,000 KISS fans.
And I can only imagine.
People say, how can you do that? And,
right.
But it really works out. We have our own private level that we can, you know, we have our rooms.
Escape a little bit
and get away if we need to. But it's a great thing, and you have fans from 34 different countries coming to the cruise, and it's very international, more than you'd think. And so, you know, it's just another KISS.
That's cool.
You know, crazy phenomenon.
It's a great year for you guys. They did a phenomenal tour. You hit up so many cities, came to Eugene, Oregon. It's great to see you back in town.
I think we saw you there, Nicole.
Yeah, I might have been backstage. I don't know how these things happen, people.
Creating some havoc back there with your friends.
Exactly. Thank you so much for sharing this app, and this is just so cool. iTunes, correct? Where can we download?
Again, you can go to the Apple iTunes app store and download Ernest Hummingbird. Just put that into the search, and you can download the app, and it's on iTunes, I think for 99 cents actually this week, and usually it's $2.99, but you know, that's nothing. It's really an enjoyable thing, and I think it's something parents can do together with their kids, watch the story. It takes about 12, 14 minutes to watch it, and there's some great music, and I think everybody will really enjoy it.
Aw, thanks so much for being here. We appreciate it so much. Welcome back to town, buddy.
Thanks, Nicole.